The Broward and Beyond Business Conference booming as hundreds filled the Signature Grand in Davie, Florida. The Broward Office of Economic and Small Business Development igniting this mega networking platform, packing in professionals looking to do business in Broward County.
I'm Dwayne Stevenson with D. Stevenson Construction. We are here at the Broward Business and Beyond Conference. It's exciting. There's so many people. You should be here.
The keynote speaker, a rocket scientist and businesswoman on her way to space. An added bonus, multiple panels with subject matter experts to answer your questions one-on-one.
We need more small businesses participating in the government procurement process.
Get certified. Find out what the opportunities are, then participate.
Welcome to Newsworthy Stories with Jacqueline Jimenez. The keynote speaker at the Broward and Beyond Business Conference was Aisha Bowe. She's a rocket scientist who has one of the fastest growing companies in the country, and she's on her way to space. During the event, her interview was live streamed, but I had a chance to sit down with her one-on-one, and what I found was intriguing was her belief system and how it had impacted her both negatively at first and then triumphantly. It changed the direction of her life. The keynote speaker at the Broward and Beyond Business Conference this year, Aisha Bowe, a rocket scientist with one of the fastest growing businesses in the country. Now she signed a contract with Blue Origin to head into space. She held a fireside chat during the conference with longtime anchor and reporter Nikki Mohan, who is now in leadership at Visit Lauderdale. But the Broward County Office of Economic and Small Business Development wanted to learn a little more about what's behind Aisha's remarkable achievements.
I want people to understand that the only limits in life are the ones that they place on themselves. Far too often, we think that if someone tells us that we can't, we shouldn't. And for me, my entire life is about breaking boundaries. I started with a 2.3 in high school. I was told I was never going to be able to go to a good school and that I was unlikely to have a prestigious career. I did both things. I went from community college to 2 degrees in aerospace engineering from one of the best schools in the country, the University of Michigan. And I went from there to work for NASA for 6 years as a federal employee, where I was in the distinguished category, which means that I was performing highly. And so that part of my life showed me that sometimes the things that people think are likely to happen are based off of things that they were told and they never tested. And so I became fascinated. What else could I do if I actually tried? I made a list and I literally wrote down, I want to go to college, I want to become someone, and I want to become a rocket scientist. Because if I do that, then I know that all of these things are true, right? The dreams are real. And one of the things that I never thought I could do was become an astronaut. And last year, I got a call completely out of the blue about an opportunity that I might fit for. I went through the interview process and I was presented with a chance to fly to space with Blue Origin. And when you get shots like that in life, you do not say no. You let them tell you no. I view everyone and everything as a business. You can be a business of one with a personal brand. We see influencers all the time making hundreds of thousands and sometimes millions on TikTok, on Instagram, as a business that would not have been conceivable decades ago. I've seen people who are great at baking cakes or making crafts create Etsy stores or Shopify stores and sell their things online, and they are also a business. And so the first thing that I like to remind people when I talk about my journey is, in order for me to become a business, I first had to see myself as a business. And once I realized that, I started to get practical exposure to foundations of business. I, in my journeys, have not found a comprehensive study of business that suits a startup. I find a lot of business programs that do a really good job at teaching you how to run something that is established. But when you want to create your own, it's important that you get out there and understand that failure is success and progress. I have been fascinated by this idea of skills and a skills-based economy. While I would love everyone to go out and get a four-year degree, it may not become necessary in the future. There are many things that you can use that can enhance your skills early on. And one of the things that my team and I actually created is called Lingo. It's a self-paced coding kit that teaches the fundamentals of computer science through hands-on electronics at home. Last year, we started tinkering with one box. That one box turned into us delivering over 6,000. We support teachers, we support countries, and you can all do it at home.
For more information on upcoming events from the Broward County Office of Economic and Small Business Development, go to broward.org/econdev. That's econdev. What an incredible interview with Aisha Bowe. We look forward to hearing more about what she's going to do in space. But it was her belief system that really caught my attention. And it's something we all can relate to. What we believe impacts every decision that we make. And so one of the other things I wanted to share with you was that alpha. Alpha is a grouping that you may have heard me talk about this before. But alpha talks about your belief system because what you believe determines every decision that you make. Here's a look at what alpha is trying to explore.
Every day we ask so many questions. What should I wear? What's the weather going to be like? How am I going to fit everything in? But then there are those bigger questions. Like, why am I here? Where am I heading? Is there more to life than this?
I had arrived at an answer to the most important issue that we humans ever deal with. Is there a God? And I had arrived there without ever really looking at the evidence. And I was supposed to be a scientist.
At 28, I had gotten many of the things that I thought I wanted. My girlfriend was on the cover of magazines, I had a Beamer, and I was so unhappy. It was a realization maybe that I would never find happiness where I was looking for it.
I think for so many years, you know, I always just strive to be strong in myself. All I needed was me and my buddies and, you know, we'd be like invincible. But the truth is, none of us are.
And I found purpose, I found meaning, I found hope. God took something so broken and made it a beautiful art piece.
Alpha is a place where you can be yourself. You can say what you think and challenge everything. No question is too complex or too simple. And what your point of view is as important as anyone else's.
We are going on a journey together, an adventure to explore the questions of life, faith, and meaning.
Now, that video is part of a film series of documentaries on testimonies from people around the world on what they believe and what they don't believe. And it's something that each of us, if we don't take the time to do that, to understand our belief system, then who impacted us or who made us believe certain things is how we live our lives. And so this film series is offered in different ways all around the world, usually through churches or organizations, and sometimes they're in person and sometimes they're virtual. Well, there is one coming up starting on Thursday, and you can explore life, faith, and meaning. It's done in a group setting, and these are not sermons, as you can see from that video. It's an actual documentary film series. And basically what you do is you watch a film that's usually about 20 minutes long, and then we discuss it. You know, what you believe, what you don't believe. But as you begin to discuss faith and what you believe about faith, what you don't believe about faith, you begin to think about who has reflected your belief system. What is your belief system about? What is the foundation of what you believe? And you'll be surprised to understand who's controlling your mind, who's behind the decisions you make. I find it fascinating. This is my fifth alpha, and I'm inviting you to attend this one. This one's online. So this one you can attend from anywhere in the world. It begins at 7:30 p.m. Just go to the parkridgechurch.com, and you can click on events, and it'll take you to the website you see on the screen. But join us and see what that experience is like. And again, there's no commitment. You can come, see what it's about, stay, go. But any night that you attend, and this is about 8 weeks or so, that we'll meet on Thursday nights at 7:30 p.m. And we go through this film series, and you will hear testimonies, and you'll be like, wow, I'm blown away every time. Every time I learn something new. And so I keep inviting people. And actually, you know, I almost, because I know this is affiliated with the church, and people get so funny, you know, every time it's something is affiliated with the church. But I'm even interested in hearing, you know, if you would do this film series just like through LinkedIn, just through business, I would love to hear about it, because I would love to do this series on LinkedIn alone. If you think if it needs to not be affiliated with the church, the whole point is take the time, carve out, understand your belief system, because you're never going to take the time to do it. And you could be making decisions based on something that's not true, based on something that, or a person who was in authority over you that really didn't have you in mind. And so this is something that helps you get to the bottom of what you believe and how you make some of the most important decisions of your life. And that's why I invite you to do that. Along these same lines of belief system, one of the things that we have been talking about over and over again, especially in the media, is our coping mechanisms. That falls in line with our belief system. How we handle things. Should we ask for help? Should we not ask for help? How do we cope in this life? Well, I want to help you. You know, there are definitely more avenues, more people talking about mental health, more people talking about ways to strengthen your mind, taking the pressure off of your reputation, if you will. We have put so much emphasis on our reputation. We don't even know who we are sometimes. And so being able to have a place to go, maybe you won't go to a church. Maybe you need to start somewhere. Maybe your belief system says, I can't go near a church. I can't do anything related to God. You need to go somewhere. And so this is all about belief system. And one of the things that is coming up is something called the Unmasked Gala. It's an event around the Healing Arts Institute, which offers no cost mental health services. And I just want to end the show today just reflecting on some of the words from Dr. Thelma Tenney, who is the CEO and founder of the Healing Arts Institute, which was actually created in honor of her son, Carter Bonus, who you've seen multiple stories on Newsworthy Stories, because it was autism. When he was diagnosed with autism, he was severely bullied. And she was a mental health therapist, and he was bullied to the point where he was ready to take his life. And so she created this nonprofit to bring attention to the fact that there should be no cost in mind when it comes to dealing with your mental health, because that's how important it is. It should be just like a mental health checkup, you know, or a health checkup, because it's a part of your health, your mental health. And so, like I said, just want to end the show on just some of the things that the stories that I've covered about the Healing Arts Institute, but particularly inviting you also to the Unmasked Gala, because it's a fun event and it takes that stigma away from mental health. But at the same time, you're able to ask all the questions you want. The mental health therapists are in the room and you can just, you know, fellowship with them, talk to them and get to know them. And so here's another invitation, this time to the Healing Arts Institute's Unmasked Gala, which is coming up, and it's just a fun event at the end of the day. And you can invite your children. Your children are also welcome. They have a separate ballroom for the children to have a gala as well. And Carter will be there. So you'll get a chance to, you know, meet Carter as well. So I invite you to do that. And just thanks so much for listening to this very personal show. And I hope you enjoyed it. Share it. Thanks for watching Newsworthy Stories with Jacqueline Jimenez.
You know, a lot of times we don't think we need therapy, but there is something missing, and we don't want to be labeled as crazy or the person who can't seem to pull it together. And I just encourage you to think of therapy this way. And one of my clients defined it as this. And so he's in therapy and he was having a bit of a time. And again, the stigma attached to receiving therapy still caused him to think, okay, I don't need therapy today, Dr. Tenney, but I need to talk to you. I need to see you. And his exact words were, I don't need therapy. I just need to come and vent, and we talk about some strategies to get through what I'm going through. And I giggled and I said, oh, kind of sounds like therapy to me, right? So if you can look at therapy as that place for you to go and vent and then develop some strategies how to deal with whatever it is you're dealing with, that's exactly what therapy is. It is not this thing that society has made it to be where something is wrong with you. Nothing is wrong with you. We're all going through the same things, myself included, my son and I included. We have our own therapist people too. You think there's nothing that this person can tell me that I haven't already thought of and tried. And that's why I'm not gonna go. I promise you, I, with two PhDs, think the same thing. There is nothing that a therapist can lend to me that I don't already know that I haven't tried. And every time I go in with my therapist, I gain a new perspective, a new something that I did not think of to try.
The Healing Arts Institute of South Florida, a leader in the community by helping children and their families heal from exhaustion and anxiety with no-cost mental health services.
On the outside, I seemed like I had everything going together, but on the inside, I was drowning.
Under the leadership of Dr. Thelma Tenney, the Healing Arts diverse team of competent therapists and staff provide therapy and family fun activities. Don't suffer in silence. Let Healing Arts help you heal. A South Florida nurse hoping to help save lives by talking about her need for mental health services. She first started opening up on social media. Now she's sitting down with her therapist, Dr. Thelma Tenney of Healing Arts Institute of South Florida, and sharing her story on camera.
If there ever was a time that we need to access mental health therapy or speak to a professional about our mental well-being as nurses or anyone really who have worked over the last 2 years in the healthcare field, it's now. I know a lot of companies are focusing on accessing mental health because they recognize that, especially in our field, that a lot of us are facing burnout. I personally was not in the ER on a day-to-day basis, but I was in the operating room and just dealing with taking care of patients during the COVID pandemic and even post-COVID era, which we're still not out of, but we're still dealing with that on a day-to-day basis. Not like it was in 2020, but I think that there is a lot of post-traumatic stress having experienced and seen people die minute by minute, hour by hour, and with trying to help to save lives, and sometimes it was just futile because of this disease. Now, what we're seeing now and what a lot of us are experiencing is the trauma from living through that. And so I think it's crucial for those of us that are facing these stressors to access mental health therapy. We can't fix this on our own. And I know we're fixers. And a lot of times we think that we've gotten this. We're providers, we're healers. So we know how to heal others. So we should be able to heal ourselves. And we're not able to all the time. And for those of us that are still struggling with the trauma of experiencing multiple deaths on a daily basis, or the inability to save everyone, because that's our job. Our job is to save people, and we weren't able to do that. We're now suffering the consequences of those failures that we perceive as failures, but really it was out of our hands. Let's access mental health. Let's seek professional help to just process grief and the outcome of not being able to save everyone.
But what therapy has done for me is given me an opportunity to deal with traumas that you don't realize just takes a little piece of you, and it impacts how you interact with others and how you go through your day. And having spent the time, which for me, which you was a long time, it was weekly, then bi-weekly, then once a month, then every other month, and consistently for probably 18 months until I felt I can breathe. And now I have the tools to just help myself process things when I come through challenges in life, help myself in setting boundaries in my life. That is one of the things that I got from therapy, setting boundaries in the people, especially loved ones, because sometimes you don't realize that area in your life too, you do need to set boundaries with the people that are closest to you.
I'm on social media, right? And I follow my clients and they follow me, and that's okay. And that's how we check up on each other. And I saw recently that Carla has been posting a lot different, and you have become a mental health advocate and sharing your story. And that is amazing to me, again, just to be able to assist someone in their journey. And I always tell you guys that my goal is for me to not need me.
You sure do. You do tell us that.
So that is my ultimate goal, as you said, to point out what skills you already have, help you develop additional skills, and then I pull out. And as you so eloquently said, once a year, right, you come in for that checkup, or when there's that life-changing event, there's the death in the family, there's the baby, there's the move, there's the new relationship, for all right. of those high-stress situations. So I'm honored. I'm honored to be your therapist, and I'm honored to have you share your experience. And again, I say it all the time, I truly do love what I do. And maybe that's just why I have such great clients.
And it shows that you love what you do. The compassion is always there. And as I mentioned before, the connection was there, and that helps a lot too. Thank you very much again.
Well, thank you. I know we're both so uncomfortable sitting here on this couch.
Not really.
Healing Arts Institute of South Florida offers mental health services to adults, but is known for offering no-cost mental health services primarily to youth 22 and younger, along with their families. For more information, go to healingartssfl.org. The Healing Arts Institute's third annual Unmasked Gala, now open for sponsorships and registration. Get your tickets today at healingartssfl.org/gala. Here's a look at what happened last year.
I've been on a low, I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. It feels like my life ain't mine. I finally wanna be alive.